Hello everyone out there watching this video. My name is Julius Mugaga from Matika Limited, the innovators of Matika, a local mathematics teaching tool for students and pupils. But before we go ahead, what is Matika addressing? Matika is addressing the problem that is most known to you. The highlight here is school systems today does not encourage mathematics learning among non-motivated students. And statistically, nearly 45% of the learners in Uganda finish their grade 5 without the minimum competence skills in numeracy. You realize that pedagogical practices have remained conventional and COVID-19 only worsened the problem. So what is our solution? The solution was to develop Matika cards, a novel low-cost mathematics card game, which allows learners to have fun with mathematics while they play and socially interact with their parents, teachers, and peers. The pictures you see down are the demos of Matika, and we shall see the details as we go on. So about Matika, it's a deck of 46 cards. 36 of the cards are labeled with numbers 1 to 9, each bearing arithmetic operators of plus, minus, multiplication, and division. There are pairs of special cards like addition, subtraction, square, square root signs, and two more cards assigned the number 0. So from the extreme left, you could see the pictures, the cards 1 to 9. We of course skipped 2, 3, 4, and the others for representation. Then the markers, which bear zeros, the minus, squares, and the root. Each deck is packed with game rules. And what are the rules when you are playing this game? At the beginning of the game, a target figure, which we call a cumulative total or totem table, is agreed upon by the players. These players can be 2 or more. This can be a number which is above 10, and anyone who plays a card that gives a target wins the game. The game starts with a 0, and then as you play, there will be increments and decrements. The first card to be put should bear addition or subtraction. So that means that the game starts in a negative or positive. The players then start playing the cards one at a time while playing these, juggling these mathematical operators. So the other game rules are that each new card placed, the cumulative total changes. And after playing a card, the cumulative total on table should be a summation, a difference, a square, or a root of the former total on table. And the player should audibly pronounce the new cumulative total. The game is won, like I said, when the agreed upon total is placed on table. So there are special rules to this game. Some of the special rules that this special card of addition and subtraction are played whenever you want to play more than 2 cards, and these are placed as sandwich. So they help the kids to learn what happens when you put a plus near plus, a plus near minus, a minus near minus. And then the marker, whenever it's played, you return 0. The total is always 0. So if you want to control the game, you want to bring the game down, you only play the marker. Every time you play, you pronounce the cumulative total. Every time you play, you replace also the cards because the power depends in the number of cards you have at hand. So there are game fines to this game. Only integer totals are played, or else someone loses a card. And that's because it's mental work. Playing more than one card without a summation or subtraction leads to a fine, which is losing a card. And also using a combination of summations or subtraction leads to loss of a card. Mentioning a wrong total is definitely inviting a fine, which is losing a card. We've taken a development journey, which has been a slow but sure process. We started this process in 2017, and in 2017 and 2018, we managed to complete the ideation and proof of concept development process. And in 2019, we started on our piloting, improvement and optimization. And in the same year, we incorporated the company, Matika Limited, and obtained copyright for Matika Card. We entered our market in 2020, and signed a distribution agreement with Shunem Systems. We dispatched 4,000 cards that had been mass produced from China. We opted for China because we had seen that we could have low cost of production. And yes, it proved to be that. The success to record that year is we won $5,000 from Big Ideas to do prototype optimization. We expect to expand our production and get more partners and scale up in 2021 and beyond. During the testing of this game, we considered the category of participants. 15 primary schools participated in this study, 10 secondary schools, and one university. A total of 700 participants were in this test process. We're using a Likert scale. Participants were tested on the ease with which they would play this game confidently after a single cycle of coaching and later after several cycles of coaching. The scores, as you can see, 68, 75, 76, 87, for P4, P5, P6, P7, respectively. All participants from secondary schools were able to score above 97%. So you can see some of the kids enjoying this game in some districts in Uganda, in Uero. So the current impact is that we have a community of 4,000 users at the moment. And the key attributes that we trade for this game are the four cognitive attributes. Attention, we are able to attract each learner's attention even in the most distracting situations. The memory is because you are supposed to play mental work and memorize some of these totals and also the route that you play. Prediction is because you must keep track of the opponent's play and then predict what would be the risk circumstances in the game if you are to win. The higher executive thinking is decision making on choosing what card to play when, a critical thinking and other planning and strategy development skills. The current partners we have are NGO-based schools, private and government academic institutions, that's mainly universities and departments, and distribution partners like Shunem Systems. Our team is in three segments. We have a core Mathika team, which leads the development of this product. I am the CTO, and Brian, my co-founder also, is the MD. And we have the distribution team led by Baraba Timothy, and we have the research and advisory team at Makerere University, led by Dr. Robert Sechitoleko. Thank you very much. I thank you for listening to me.